Hello friends, I am Manisha Nifade, junior college teacher, subject English, working in Red Shikshan Samstha's Rao Bahadur Narayan Rao Borauke College, Srirampur. Friends, today we are going to know about the lesson which is in your syllabus 11th standard. Title of the lesson is The Call of the Soil. It is 1.3. See, friends, in general, when we think about our health, we consider some issues. First, when we go to market, we look for vegetables and fruits. What is the reason behind it? See, we all like to eat the healthy food, and that's why we avoid junk food and other items and we concentrate on vegetables and fruits. And second point is wash and peel. When we brought things at home, it may be vegetables or fruits, at first we wash them. See, there are various reasons why we wash them. Because we know that nowadays, people are using, or farmers are using the fertilizers, chemicals in their crop. And that is why when we bring these things like apple or other vegetables, we first wash them. And the fruits which we can peel, we peel them like banana, we peel them, or apple, we peel, chiku, these are the things which we wash and peel, and vegetables are also there. See the word adulteration. Adulteration, all of us know about that. See, to make the quantity more, to increase the quantity, people are using this adulteration. For example, see, when they are selling the chili powder, in chili powder, they are using the brick powder to increase the quantity. Same way, they are increasing the milk. And adulteration is very familiar in general, which is very dangerous to our health. And we are trying this, we are trying to avoid for the health issue this adulteration. Next word is organic food. What is this organic food? See, nowadays we are listening this word organic. Organic means in the farm, farmers are not using pesticides or chemicals to grow the crop. And all of us know the effects of chemicals. And lot of diseases are there, which are the result of these chemicals and fertilizers. Now, see, pesticides, organic food, which is very simple, where these all things are not used, pesticides and chemicals, which is original food, we prefer organic food to other conventional food. Next is organic fertilization. See, in the farm, we use the fertilizers. All chemical fertilizers, we know that. But other fertilizers, means cow dung or compost, compost fertilizer is there, which is the wastage of vegetables and fruits and other things, which is very useful, and it is called the organic fertilization. Friends, when you go to grocer's shop, in that shop, when you demand the varieties of rice, or we demand the rice, the shopper tells us there are various varieties. All of us know that Indrayani is there, Basmati is there, Chinor is there, Delhi rice, lot of varieties of rice are available in the grocer's shop. But do you know that these all are not the original rice? It is the not the organic rice. It is the hybrid rice which all of us prefer, because we like its beauty. When we grow, when we cook it, all of us like its smell and such a way. We like these variety, but we don't know what is the original rice. And now, let us see our parents and grandparents. See, do you know that when you sit with your grandparents, they remind the various things. They tell you the stories of their childhood, how they were eating the mangoes and how those mangoes were delicious and very sweet. Their taste was quite different. About your parents, they also tell you the stories of bananas, lady's fingers, how at that time they were the original items. And we just listen the discussions, but we don't know the taste of organic or original food. Now see, there is difference between conventional and organic food. What is the difference? See, in conventional food, conventional farming, it is the farming. Our farmers, which they are taking the crops in the field. There is a big difference in conventional and organic farming. First point is there. Conventional farming, they produce larger quantities of food. See, a lot of tons they take the crops of these types. Means in conventional farming. But in organic farming, you see they cannot take lot of crop. Their quantity is less because they are using another chemical. They are not using the chemicals. But here in conventional farming, fertilizers, chemicals are there, and due to these chemicals, they get the larger variety of crops. In organic farming, it is not possible. Now see, second point is less manual labor. In conventional farming, see, our farmers are calling the tractors and other harvesting machines, and they are taking lot of quantity at a time in their field. But in organic farming, you see, there is manual work. They are preferring the persons instead of machines in this organic field farming. And third point is extra use of chemicals and pesticides. Yes, in conventional farming, if you want to avoid the things which are troublesome to crop, they use the chemicals and pesticides. In other thing, means organic farming, it is more ecological, it is good for health, and their fertilizers are like cow dung and compost fertilizer is there. And that is why this organic farming, all of us know that it is very good, but we are not getting organic things in daily wages. See, now I would like to tell you the title of the lesson, The Call of the Soil. Friends, you know that. Call means what? See, when your parents or your father tells you that there is a call from your friend, means someone is calling you and he wants to talk with you. Here, the call of the soil, soil means earth. Here, your own earth, your own land is calling you. Whom it is calling? See, the writer of the lesson is Venkat Iyer. Let us take some information about the writer. See, the name of the writer is Venkateshwaran Iyer, and he is called the Venkat Iyer. Born in 1966, Venkateshwaran Iyer is a science graduate. See friends, he is now entering into farming, but actually he is a science graduate and a certified project management professional. See, once upon a time, he was getting the a lot of salary, very big salary, but he thought that this is not the good thing. I have to do another thing, and that's why he entered in another field. Let us see his information. He last worked with IBM. See, Venkat Iyer was working in the very famous international company, it is IBM, International Business Machines, name of the company. And it is the American multinational company. He was working with multinational company and getting the great salary. IBM in Mumbai as a project manager for software implementation. See, he was in computer work. He were developing the softwares. And after 17 years in the IT industry, he quit in 2004. Continuously 17 years, he worked in IT information technology field. But after that, he decided to quit it, to come out of it. He quit in 2004. Why he quit it? Why he left it? To live on his organic farm in Pet village in Dahanu Taluka. See, he bought the organic farm there. Means he bought the farm and then he changed it into organic one. In Pet village in Dahanu Taluka, Palghar district, Maharashtra. See, he wanted to change that land which was used before as a conventional land, he changed it into organic land. See, his book, the title of his book is very different. See, what is the name of his book? Moong Over Microchips. Moong Over Microchips. Moong is the crop. And microchips means when he was software engineer, he was using the microchips, and he says moog over the microchips means he has left that work and now he is working in moog means in the crop. His book Moong Over Microchips traces his transition from techie to farmer. See, there is a big transition. What is the transition? He was, once upon a time, he was a technically expert person, but now he changed himself into farmer. Over a period of 15 to 17 years, he was in techie, means technical field. It was not a career change. See, his sentence is very important. What he says, it was not a career change, but a lifestyle change I was looking for. Yes, it was not only to career change. There was even whole lifestyle was about to change. And he accepted it. He decided to become true farmer. See, he made his own home in the farm and he was taking the whole information about the every crop and where he can get the original crops, he original seeds to grow in his field, and that's why he says it was not a simple change, it was a great change. The change was in lifestyle. I was looking for, he says, about his decision to shift to the quieter environments of a village. See, it was lifestyle change. Why he says it was lifestyle change? Because he was living in Mumbai. And in Mumbai, all of you know that it's the very crowded atmosphere. People are not time to get a breath. And from that place, he came to very quieter place, very calm place. That's why it was big difference. And environment was very clean there. He insisted on practicing organic farming from the outset. See, at the beginning, very beginning, he had aim in his mind and it was the quite different aim. He decided not to do the conventional farming. He should do different type of farming and it is the organic. Organic farming from the outset, he was resolute means he was firm for his decision, resolute in spite of numerous challenges which he faced. See, when he was doing this organic farming, there were lot of obstacles, difficulties, but he faced them. Firmly he faced them. He was resolute about them. And today, not only, friends, now he has become so familiar that he was delivering the lectures over the organic farming. Today, not only does he deliver lectures on organic farming, but also has joined hands with organic farmers and NGOs. See, like the Popatrao Pawar, he also guiding the people in Maharashtra about the ideal villages. This person, Venkat Iyer, is guiding the persons about the organic farming. He has developed his own field, as well as he is helping the another NGOs which are interested in organic farming. He is propagating, he is spreading this organic farming in whole Maharashtra. What he says, see, in the last, fail to propagate organic farming to ensure that the land at least is not ravaged while they try to make a living out of agriculture. See, he is emphasizing that our land, which other farmers are using, and they are doing the conventional farming, he emphasizing that they should not destroy the land by using chemicals. Keep it original, its own inner base should be there, and that's why he is wandering in all over the Maharashtra and guiding the people for organic farming. After that, in the next video, let us see the lesson itself. Thank you.